on the high school, you have to pass the OGT, you have to pass all 5 parts to graduate. And I know a lot of my friends who were stressing this year about the OGT, they're seniors, and they're going back and forth like, oh, am I going to graduate or this or that? And it's like we should have tutoring or, like, to prevent all that, like, really, what is this OGT test for? I mean, we've been going to school for 13 years, and it comes to this last year that you're trying to, you know, graduate. And it's holding a lot of kids back. Like, I mean, I know a lot of kids who wants to go to college, wants to have a good career. And it's like, that's all people really want is a good education to, you know, provide for their family or make money or do whatever it is that they want to do. And it's like, I would have, like, a program for a school that helps kids and, like a professional. I know a lot of girls who like to dance, and I know a lot of guys who like to rap, like, just things that we like. And as far as, like, I know kids, they want to have money, they like to look nice, so, you know, a program that will help kids, like, do internships or get jobs, you know, something that they like and, like, they will participate in. I think that would attract a lot of kids.
Excuse me, before you take off. You emphasized OGT test when you spoke before. What would you want us as parents to do? Because that's obviously a problem for you, right? What can we do now that you have a lot of influential community persons in this room? What do you think we should be doing to address this problem that you see in the school with the OGT test?
The problem that I see is, well, we start off taking the OGT test our sophomore year. And we have they give us like maybe 4 tries to pass it, but some kids don't pass it at all. And I think it's like maybe 4 more chances, I really don't know what it is, but it's like some kids pass it, some don't. And it's like, I think, me personally, I think they should just, you know, eliminate it. I mean, because if you keep trying to help a person and they're not getting it, they're not passing it, you start off taking it your sophomore year, you can't pass it, it's like, why? I mean, why?
Does the test relate to any level of the next step in terms of education, college? Is it a prelude to them being able to get into college?
You can't graduate without it.
You can't graduate without it. You can't graduate
One thing I was going to say about with Akir.
Like this year I was in school, like, I've been went to school my whole life for 13 years, and up until my last 12th grade year, I've been trying to pass this OGT, and it's like, I couldn't pass it, so, like, my last choice was to just go ahead and get my GED. And it's like, I went to school all these years, and it's like, I had to drop out my 12th grade year because I knew, like, I've been trying, and I just didn't pass it, so I had to just go and get my GED, which, I mean, it's like, why, you know?
Your grade level, all the years was good?
Yeah.
And the thing I was going to say about that was, she didn't pass the OGT, but she took her GED practice and did not study and pass all 5 parts 40 points over in every section. But she couldn't pass OGT. Didn't study for the GED, but passed it, all 5 parts.
She took a pre-ACT? Did you take an ACT or SAT?
No, because you have to pass your OGT in order to take the ACT or SAT.
But you know, I think the missing component about the OGT that people don't understand is that even though our youth are taught, they say the teachers teach to the test, we don't understand how the OGTs are graded. I was so frustrated that I actually went to go grade the OGTs this year. Because I was like, what's going on? I'm not understanding this. And there's a group of people right here on Morris Road, and we sit in front of a computer, and they give you these numbers. Like, you actually, we get your little survey that you write, your little paragraphs and all that kind of stuff, and they give us a rubric saying, okay, if they include 3 points, you get 3, you get 2 points if you report 2 or whatever. But when I read that, it's subject to my interpretation. So that means what I give you is what you get. And so if I'm in a bad mood or grumpy, and I'm tired, and I read it in a bad way or something, and I give you a one, you now have a one. And that's what goes through. And with the math, they give us these little, they give us these things, and they give us the answers and how you need to write it out or whatever. But it's all about how you wrote it out, how you broke it down, and if I determine that you wrote it the right way. And when you have 150 people in a room, all up in a computer, and we're all looking, and you're there from like 8:30 in the morning to 4:30, you have the option to be in there at different times. And if you're tired or if you're bored, when you're sitting there reading that whole time, you can get bored with that. I literally was like, I can't do this. No, this is so boring just sitting here. And these are the people that are given a grade that gives the OTT and determines if the people are passing or not. And
are you
You don't have to be a certified educator. All you
tell me anybody. You have to have a college.
No, you have to have a college degree. So you have to have a bachelor's degree.
I have a college degree. I'm the first to tell everybody. This is my book.
Exactly. You have to have a bachelor's degree, and oftentimes you do get a lot of retired teachers doing it because
you have 2 minutes.
But some people, so it all depends on how long you've had your degree, how you interpret the training. We get like you get like a day and a half of training.
Okay.
Okay, real quick, we have two minutes left in the session, and I know a couple of kids wanted to respond to Hatem's question.
Can I say one thing? I was asking about would you take the pre-ACT or the ACT, because in order for us to make this thing go away, we got to be able to show something. I'm thinking that if you did good through school, and you was able to take a pre-ACT or ACT, because I don't think you need to pass OGT in order to take it, because they charge. If we was to get you the test so that you could take the ACT, so we could look at your ACT score and compare it with the OGT score, and if you pass ACT and you can get into any college, that'll give the people that don't believe in this OGT some ammunition to go to these state legislators and put this stuff together and say, look, we got an individual who graduated, what's your grade point average?
It was like a 3.0.
She got a 3.0, she didn't pass OGT, but she got a 17 on the ACT. Something's wrong.
Absolutely.
Something's wrong.
But you know we have this discussion. Okay, you have 19, whatever, but you
have kids without the training, all the training. Okay, we want to let the kids play, because we're really out of time. It's a valid point, but there's nothing we can do. We want to let the kids finish and wrap up. Who's next?
I was just going to answer about that.
Let's go ahead and talk about the program, because there was a question asked. What would you want to see if you had the money?